Revolution means any object should make 360 degree turn. A cylinder is having two centers with a circular basis. These two centers, if you join, you will get the axis. Okay, this is axis because this has axis. Around this axis, if this make a turn, suppose this point, let us say this is a PQ is the line. This line edge goes like this, completely makes one round and comes back to the same position. Then we call it as revolved once. One revolution has taken place. So like this, a road roller. What is the shape of a road roller? So road roller, you know that it is cylindrical. So you assume that this is cylindrical. Okay, this is a road roller. So vehicle with the cylindrical wheel with a heavy weight. So this is a road roller. It makes how many revolutions? 750 revolutions. So it rotates, it revolves 750 times. So now to move once over the level road. So it has to move over a level road. To level a road, it makes 750 revolutions. Okay. Find the area of the road if the diameter of the road roller is 84 centimeter. So complete road will be actually rolled over. This is rolls over the complete road. And during that rolling over that road, it makes 750 revolutions. Now you have to find out the area of the road. You have to find out the area of the road using this information. Okay. For it makes, I told you, 750 revolution. Now what is the area it covers when it makes one revolution? Area covered by the road roller. Area. In one revolution, how much area it covers? It is equal to
the lateral surface area of the
lateral surface area. It is equal to curved surface area. Curved surface area of roller. Okay. So it is equal to, this is curved surface area of this area. This one, it is curved surface only. So once it makes a revolution, it covers an area which is equal to its curved surface area. One revolution is equal to, area covered by one revolution is equal to this curved surface area, CSA, curved surface area of this roller. So now, what is the formula to find the curved surface? Because it is cylindrical in shape, the formula to find the 2 pi r. So now, you look at this. This road roller is having the dimensions. So if the diameter of the road roller is 84 cm, diameter is equal to 84 cm and the length of the meter, the length is equal to, length means you can take here height, so h is equal to 1 meter. Okay, now this is in centimeter and this is in meter, you cannot give the same different units for the same question. Either you convert this into meter or this one into centimeter. Okay, so let us convert them into same units now. So if you convert this into meter, divide this by 100. So it becomes 0.84 meter. It becomes 0.84 meter. Okay. Once you convert this into centimeter to meter, okay, centimeter, now it will be 0.84 divided by 100, converted into meter. So now I want the radius. So height is 1 meter, diameter is 0.84 meter, therefore radius. So radius will be equal to 0.84 divided by 2. 0.42 meter. 0.42 meter. So we converted everything into meters. Otherwise you can keep in centimeter also, no problem. So now you can substitute here 2 into 22 by 7. Radius, it is 0.42. Height is 1 meter. Now you can simplify this one. Simplify this one. 7 on the 7.
Then 2.64 meters.
0.06. It is equal to 0.06. Now you are getting 22 2s of 44. 44 into 0.06. Into 1 is same.
Then 2.64 meters.
2. you multiplied it, 2.64 meters square. Okay, so this is the area covered by the roller in one revolution. But it is making how many revolutions?
750 revolutions.
Let us take area covered by the roller. Area covered by roller in 750 revolutions is equal to 750 2.64.
The lateral surface area of cylinder roller is 2.70.
Okay. You have multiplied this one. 1000?
Yes, sir. 980
meters square. Okay, 1980 meters square. Good. So, this is the total area covered by the road roller. So, therefore, this itself is the area of the road. So, area of road is equal to 1980 meters square. Question number 10 is like this. A company packages its milk powder, in a cylindrical container. The shape of the container is cylinder, whose base has a diameter 14 cm, base diameter 40 cm, height is 20 cm. Okay, company places a label around the surface area of the container. If the label is placed 2 cm from the top and bottom, what is the area of the label? So let us draw one diagram of a cylinder. So you can take this itself as the cylindrical container where the milk powder is packed. Okay, this is a cylindrical container where the milk powder is packed. And the company puts a label, wraps the label around this curved surface. So let us put a tiny wrapper here. So like this, a wrapper will be placed here, covered on this curved surface. So here milk powder, like that something they will write, so milk powder. So now this is the place that is covered by this, this is the wrapper around this curved surface. And how they are placing the wrapper here, from here to here it is 2 cm. They have left 2 cm at the top and 2 cm at the bottom. So 2 cm gap is given, from here to here it is 2 cm. So now, total, look at the data that they have given. Diameter 14 cm. That means from here to here, it is 14 cm. Okay, then total height is 20 cm. Height of the cylinder is 20 cm. This height is 20 cm. Now what are the things required to find the area of this wrapper?
Radius,
what is the area of the label? We want to find out the area of label. Area of label, it is curved surface area, that is 2 pi r h only. We need to have this radius and height, height of the label. So since the diameter is 14 cm, therefore radius will be 7 cm. Okay, and here, you should not take the total height of the cylinder, entire cylindrical container you should not take. So height of the label.
So 20 minus 2 plus 2.
So height of label, we have to take only the label height, not the width. So that is equal to total 20 minus here 2 cm 2 plus 2. You have to subtract 2 plus 2.
20 minus 4.
16 cm. Look at this. At the top you have to minus minus. Here bottom also you have to minus 2 cm. Here 2 cm, here 2 cm. Total 4 cm should be subtracted from the total height. That gives you the height of this label. Okay. Now you can substitute in this formula to get the area of the label. Area of the label 2 into 22 by 7 into radius. Radius is 7. Into height of this label. Height of the label is 16. Very careful, don't get confused here. Instead of writing 16, don't write 20. See, if you take the 20, it gives the curved surface of the entire this milk container. But we want only the area of this label, you have to take only this much. much height. So now you can simplify here, 7 and 7 cancels. You are left with 2 into 22 into 16. So you multiply, you will get the answer in centimeters square. After the multiplication, you will get 704 centimeters square. So this is the area of the label. Area of label is equal to 704 centimeters square. So they asked only to find you what is the area of the label. So we got area of the label is 704 centimeters square. Look at this now. Let us go to volume. Volume of any object. Let us take volume. Volume means amount of space occupied by a three-dimensional object. Three-dimensional object means maybe cube, cuboid, or like that. Suppose here is a cube. So how much space it occupies? So this is the boundary. All the edges are the boundary of this solid. Whatever that is inside, that is there, that occupies this space. This solid occupies how much space? So that space is called its volume. Okay. So volume is nothing but the space occupied by three-dimensional object. It is called its volume. Suppose we have kept one almirah inside a room. Almirah, you know that. Almirah you have seen, now in your home they might have kept with the two doors. Now you can keep glass, everything. Like a cuboidal box it is, with the doors. So you have kept an almirah that occupies less space compared to the room. You have kept almirah inside the room means the volume of the room is much greater than the volume of the almirah. So it is only comparison between the volumes. How much space it occupies inside the room, that is the volume of the almirah. So how much space occupied by the room, in this space it is called its volume. So now let us see what is the area and the volume. Area means it is a region enclosed by the plane figure. Plane figure means like the triangles. Triangle, square, having only two dimensions. Whatever the region, this region, whatever the region that is enclosed, this region is called as its area. We call this as area. Region enclosed by the closed figure. Closed plane figure. Plane figure, remember, plane figure, it is called as area, and it is always measured in square units. If it is in centimeter, square centimeter. If it is in meter, square meter. All areas are always measured in square units. Remember that. Whereas volume, it is a three-dimensional space occupied. Space occupied by 3D job, 3D object. 3D means three-dimensional. That means having length, breadth, and height. So it is always measured in cubic units. Cubic units means, so 1 centimeter cube, or 1 meter cube, or like that, 1 millimeter cube. So like this, it is always measured in cubic units. This is always measured in square units. So it is a two-dimensional figure. This is three-dimensional figures. So you got the difference between the area and volume?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, how we measure this volume? Look at this now. 1 cubic centimeter, I told, always in cubic units, I told, measured in cubic units. So what is that cubic units? Look at this. Suppose 1 cubic centimeter, I take cubic units. I have taken the unit centimeter. 1 cubic centimeter means it is nothing but 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. That is 1 centimeter cube or 1 cubic centimeter. Both are same. Either you can write like this or like this. Both are same. It is nothing but the length into breadth into height. A cube having 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter length, breadth and height respectively. 1 cubic centimeter means it is a cube, small cube. So this is a cube having the length of its edge. This edge is 1 centimeter. So this is 1 centimeter, this is also 1, this is also 1. Length is 1, breadth is 1, height is 1. Such a small cube is called as 1 cubic centimeter. This volume is 1 centimeter cube. 1 centimeter cube. You understood?
Yes, sir.
Now you want to convert this into millimeter means 1 centimeter is equal to how many millimeters?
10.
So instead of writing 1 centimeter, you can write 10 millimeter into 10 millimeter into 10 millimeter. you will get 1000 millimeter cube. 1 cubic centimeter, this 1 cubic centimeter is also equal to 1000 millimeter cube. Now suppose 1 meter cube means a cube, it's a cube having the edge length. What is the length of this edge? 1 meter and 1 meter. So 1 meter length, 100 and 100 times this one. Okay. So 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter. Such a cube is called as 1 cubic meter. Such a cube is called as 1 unit cube. 1 unit cube. Or here it is in meter, therefore 1 meter cube. So now 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter, this is the volume of this cube with length, breadth, height respectively equal to 1 meter cube. If you want to convert this into centimeter, 1 meter is equal to how many centimeters?
100
centimeters. If you write here 100, 100, 100, then you write like this, it will become how many? Say, look at this. Almost 10 lakh centimeter cube. Okay. Same way, 1 cubic millimeter means it's a cube having a small cube with the length is equal to 1 millimeter, breadth also 1 millimeter, height also 1 millimeter. Very small compared to this one. Okay. Such a cube is called as 1 millimeter cube. So now, 1 millimeter cube. Cubic millimeter means 1 millimeter into 1 millimeter into 1 millimeter. That is 1 millimeter cube. So 1 millimeter, you know that it is only 1/10 of a centimeter, or otherwise, so 0.1
centimeter.
So 0.1 into 0.1 into 0.1, it gives you 0.01 centimeter. So this is how we measure the volume of the solids or any three-dimensional objects. Now let us go to cuboid. So what is the volume of a cuboid? So let us understand now. So to find the volume of a cuboid, so let us see now how to find the volume of a cuboid. This is a cuboid having the length L units. So let us take this is the length L units, and this is the breadth B units, and this is the height H units. Length into, because it's a three-dimensional figure having three dimensions. Length, breadth, and height. So now how to find the volume of this cuboid? So now I told you, so if it is in centimeter, we will get it in centimeter cube. If it is in meter, we will get in meter cubes. That depends on the what units that you are considering. Now this entire solid has to be divided into small unit cubes. Small unit cubes. Suppose if I take one unit cube here, look at this. Having, so one unit cube means like this. This is an unit cube. So inside the cube, small cube. This is a unit cube. One unit cube means one unit in length, one unit breadth, one unit height. If it is in centimeter, 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter. That is called as 1 centimeter cube. If it is in meter, 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter. That is 1 meter cube. Whatever we can take simply 1 unit cube. So we have taken 1 unit cube. This is the space occupied by the 1 unit cube. Now, how many such unit cubes are required to fill this complete cube will be equal to the volume of this bigger cube. Cuboid. So this is a cube having length, breadth, height equal in length, equal in measure. So 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter. How many such small cubes are required to cover this complete, to occupy this complete cuboid? So that we have to find out. How many such these small cubes are required to fill this complete cuboid? So that gives you the volume of this cuboidal box or cuboidal solid. I have taken 36 cubes of this type, 36 cubes. I arranged in this way, 36 cubes I took, arranged in this way. So here in this line I have arranged 12 cubes, small cubes here. So 36 cubes are arranged like this. From here to here, how many cubes are kept along the length? How many cubes? 12, totally I have kept 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 cubes. So along the breadth, how many cubes are there? have three cubes. Three cubes. Now, and along the height we have only one along the height, only one cube. Height wise only one. Now what is the volume here? Volume is equal to, look at this, how many small cubic units we have placed here? Volume, this is in cuboidal shape. How many small cubes? This is one, this small portion represents one cubic unit. So volume, what is the volume of this one? It is one cubic unit. Cubic unit. This is one cubic unit. Okay. Now, how many cubic units are there in this arrangement? So you can count here. Here 12, second line 12, third line 12. So 12 into 3. So into 1, height is 1 is there. Therefore, 12 into 3 into 1, total 36 cubic units. So this is the volume of this cuboidal shape. We have 36 small cubes. So therefore, its volume is 36 cubic units. How to find these 36 cubic units? So we have length 12. We have 3 rows. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, 12 into 3, 36. Height only 1, into 1. So 12 into 3 into 1. So let us take another arrangement here. Look at this, same 36 cubic units are arranged in a different way here. Now let us count the number of cubic units. We should get 36 here. How many cubic units are there along the length? Count this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 cubic units. Along the breadth, how many cubic units are there? You look at this. 1, 2, 3 units. So along the height, how many we are having? 2. So now, same 36 cubic units we arranged in different way. Look at this here, 36 cubic units, 12 into 3 into 1. Here look at this, same 36 cubic units, 6 into 3. So how to find this, how many cubes are there, you can count here. Here 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, here 3, so here 12, totally in the base 12 and above 12, total 12, how many? 18, sorry, 6 into 3, 18, 18 plus 18, total 36 only. So now here, L into P into H, same way what we did here, volume is equal to, you count this, 6 into 3, if I multiply 6 into 3, I will get the number of cubes in the ground row which is at the bottom. Here 6, here 3, 6 into 3, 18. And here we have one more layer here. This is first ground row layer, another layer, second layer also we have. In the ground layer we have 18 cubes and above that also we have one layer, therefore into 2. You multiply this, 6 into 3 into 2. What is the answer you will get? 6, 3 is 18, 18 is 36. 36 cubic units. So this is the volume of this cuboidal arrangement. This is the volume. So this is also same volume, but it is different shape. Different in size or shape. 12 into 3. Okay, into 1. Here 6 into 3 into 2. We have a different arrangement here. So volume here, you are getting your after multiplication of 6 into 3 into 2. So what is this 6 here? It is length. What is here 3? It is breadth. What is here 2 here? Length. So volume of a cuboidal box can be calculated by multiplying length, breadth and height. So here also same thing, volume of this box, 12 year length, 3 year it is breadth, 1 year it is height. So L into P into H gives you the volume of this cuboid. Here also you have verified, L into P into H gives you volume of this cuboid. Even you can arrange this in a different way. Okay, different way, let us see now. One more arrangement I will show you. One more arrangement you can see. Another type of arrangement. So look at this. Now let us count the number of cubes, small cubic units that I have arranged here. So now along this length, how many cubic units are there? You have to find out now. So along this count here, it is 9. So up to here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Along the breadth, how many cubic units are there? Only
1.
So along the height, look at this, we have
4.
So we have totally how many cubic small cubic units? So it is 9 into 1 into 4. So that is 36 cubic small cubic units. So that means it is nothing but volume is equal to L. Along the length we have 9, along the breadth we have 1, along the height we have 4. So volume of this cuboidal shape is L into B into H. You understood how to find the volume of any cubes, cuboids?
Yes.
So it is nothing but length into breadth into height gives you volume of the cuboids. So it is just finding the how many small cubes are placed inside that cuboid. Here we have placed 36 cuboids, 36 cubes inside the cuboid. This cuboid of course contains 36 small cubes. This is one cube, second one, third one, like that we have placed 36 small cubes or unit cubes. So that gives you the volume of the cuboid. Is it clear to all of you? What is the formula to find the volume of the cuboid? It is length into breadth into height. This is the formula. Remember, volume of a cuboid is nothing but length into breadth into height.